Do you think that making bi-weekly payments will pay off your mortgage quicker, or that you don't need to worry about retirement because you have a pension? These are some pretty common beliefs about money, but they could actually be hurting you in the long run. And joining us this morning to dispel some simple myths about investing in finances is Peter Cishecki from Everything Financial. Good morning, Peter. Good to see you.
Nice to see you, Keri. Good morning.
So, yeah, some pretty common myths. And the first one is, I don't own mutual funds, I have RRSPs. What's the difference?
Well, the mutual funds are the type of investment, just like a term deposit, a GIC, or we talk about portfolio management. RRSP is the type of account, just like a TFSA, tax-free savings account, or your kid's RRSP, registered education savings plan. So the mutual fund can be in any one of those investments, and any one of those types of accounts can hold those investments I just mentioned. So the two are two different items, and sometimes people do get that confused and they think if they have one, they don't have the other.
Gotcha. Okay, here's another myth. Biweekly mortgage payments will pay off my mortgage faster versus monthly payments. I think that's what we've always been told.
Because the banks always want to show us how to save more money, right? And affect their bottom line. Well, if on the surface, yes, but realistically, no. In other words, if you took the same amount of money, because that biweekly payment does help with some forced savings and allow you to make that extra payment, but if you were diligent enough to take that extra money yourself and make that extra payment, it all goes to principal, not principal and interest, and it gets you a little more ahead than the biweekly payments.
Oh.
So it's not all it seems on the surface.
Interesting. Okay, good tip there. Okay, here's another myth. Independent investment companies can't protect my money like the bank can.
Yeah, and I heard this one as of yesterday from someone on the street when I was walking down the street. They asked that question. And that's not true, because banks or the independent portfolio management companies, all use what's called a custodian. A custodian is basically the vault where the money stays. These are banks that are insured by the government of Canada to protect your money. So that makes sure the mutual fund company, the portfolio management company, isn't really holding your money. They're trading your money and looking after the accounts and the portfolios. But when you put your money in, it goes into the vault of the custodian. And when you take your money out, the custodian or the vault sends it directly to you. So it's the exact same protection. This is the one that's most disturbing, because that lack of protection, lack of guarantee from, unfortunately, some people gets thrown out there all the time. And it's just not true. You have a custodian, you're protected with the bank, the independent company. The key is making sure your investments are going to the custodian. That's what you have to do as a consumer.
All right, good information there. Okay, here's another myth. Why buy a TFSA? They don't earn any interest.
Yeah, and unfortunately, since these have come out years ago, that myth is perpetuated by walking into the bank and seeing a sign that says TFSA 0.15%. I'm only saying that because I saw one 2 days ago. And people think, well, if it's in a TFSA, why bother at 0.15%? You know what? Couldn't agree with you more. Why bother at 0.15%? As we've said before, look at your TFSA as a long-term retirement type savings plan. Be more aggressive if that suits you, more like your RRSP. If you're doing a TFSA truly for something short term, okay, I get the low interest and doing something ultra conservative and short term. But realistically, the whole key to a TFSA is you're not paying tax on the money you earn. So make the money you earn worthwhile, and 0.15% just isn't worthwhile, Keri.
Peter Cishecki with Everything Financial with busting some myths for us this morning. Thanks, Peter. Have a great day.
Thanks, Keri, and happy Canada Day, one day in advance.
Okay, thanks for that.